Hi friends, welcome to Pharma Classes Learning at a Glance. I am Dr. JP. Today we are going to discuss introduction of alkaloids. One by one we are going to discuss. First one, definition of alkaloids. These are the basic nitrogenous organic compounds where nitrogen atom may or may not be in a heterocyclic ring. Mostly, alkaloids are derived from the amino acids. They have physiological actions on humans and animals. Next, functions of alkaloids. Since they have nitrogen, these are nitrogen storage reservoirs. These are also protective agents that defend the plant from predators. They have structural similarity with the growth regulators, so they are also used as growth regulators. Last function, they play an important role in protein synthesis. Next one, nomenclature. The alkaloids are end with suffix -ing. The names of the alkaloids are obtained in different ways. First one, from the species of the plant. Erythroxylon coca. Coca is a species, erythroxylon is a genus. Cocaine, which is obtained from the coca. From the genus of the plant, Atropa belladonna. Genus is Atropa. Atropine is derived from the genus Atropa. Third one, from the common name of the drug, ergot. It is a common name. Ergotamine is derived from the ergot. From the physiological activity, emetic. Emetine is derived from the emetic. From the discoverer, pelletier. Pelletierin is derived from the pelletier. Next topic, physical properties. Alkaloids are usually colorless, odorless, crystalline, non-volatile bitter solids. Exceptions are berberine and colchicine. These two are yellow in color. You see, it is a berberine which is yellow in color. Some colorless alkaloids may have colored salts. Example, hydrastinine is a colorless, but its salt is yellow color. Sanguinarin is a colorless, but its salt is red in color. Next, few alkaloidal bases are oily liquids. What are those? Arecoline, conine, nicotine, pilocarpine and spartine. See, it is a nicotine which is a liquid. Last one, few alkaloids are amorphous in nature. Example, emetine. See here, it is a emetine, amorphous in nature. Next one, solubility of alkaloids. First we are going to discuss solubility of alkaloidal free bases. They are usually soluble in organic solvents such as chloroform, ether, lower alcohols, etc. They are practically insoluble or sparingly soluble in water. Exceptions. Morphine, which is an alkaloidal free base, it is soluble in ether in the ratio of 1 in 5000. Pilocarpine and narcin are other alkaloidal bases. Those are sparingly soluble in organic solvents. Last one, some alkaloidal bases which are soluble in the water. What are those? Caffeine, ephedrine, colchicine, pilocarpine, D-tubuquirarin and berberine. So far we have discussed the solubility of alkaloidal free bases. Now we are going to discuss solubility of alkaloidal salts. These are soluble in the water. They are less soluble in alcohols. They are insoluble or sparingly soluble in the organic solvents. Exceptions are quinine sulfate, which is sparingly soluble in the water. That is 1 in 1000. Next, some alkyl salts are soluble in the organic solvents. What are those? Apoatropin hydrochloride and lobelin hydrochloride, which are soluble in the chloroform. Next, occurrence and distribution. Alkaloids are generally present in plants in the form of salts of succinic acid, malic acid, acetic acid, tannic acid, oxalic acid, tartaric acid, etc. But occasionally they are found in salts with inorganic acids. Example, morphine in opium present as morphine sulfate. Next, third one. Sometimes they are also found in combination with the special acids like aconitic acid in aconite, phenic or syncotannic acid in syncona alkaloids, meconic acid in opium alkaloids. Last one. Alkaloids are also found in combination with sugars, hence they are called glucoalkaloids. Example, solanine, which is a glucoalkaloid, upon hydrolysis it gives sugar along with a glycone, solanidine, which is an alkaloid. Next one, next topic, chemical properties. Based on the nature of nitrogen atom, alkaloids are four types. First one, primary alkaloids. Second one, secondary alkaloids. Third one, tertiary alkaloids. Fourth one, quaternary alkaloids. First, we are going to discuss primary alkaloids. These are formed by the removal of hydrogen from ammonia with either alkyl group or aryl group. This is the basic nucleus. Example of primary alkaloids, mesalin. Next, secondary alkaloids. These are formed by the removal of two hydrogens from ammonia with alkyl group or aryl group. This is the basic nucleus. Example of secondary alkaloid is ephedrine. Next, tertiary alkaloids. Tertiary alkaloids are formed by the removal of three hydrogens from ammonia with either alkyl group or aryl group. This is the basic nucleus. Example, morphine. Most tertiary amine alkaloids are easily converted to N-oxides when exposed to light and oxygen at elevated temperatures. These N-oxides have water solubility, delayed release, minimal toxicity, and no addictive properties when compared to their parent tertiary alkaloids. Last one, quaternary alkaloids. These are positively charged polyatomic structure. This is a basic nucleus. Example, D-tubo-quinarine. Next topic, basicity of alkaloids. The basicity of alkaloids is due to the presence of lone pair of electrons on the amine nitrogen atom. Unsaturation decreases the basicity. Example, piperidine alkaloids are more basic than pyridine alkaloids. This is piperidine, this is pyridine. Presence of electron releasing groups increases the basicity. Example, alkyl groups. The presence of electron withdrawing groups decreases the basicity. Example, carbonyl groups. Next topic, optical activity. Due to presence of one or more asymmetric carbon atoms in their molecule, many alkaloids are optically active. Optically active isomers exhibit a variety of physiological functions. Generally, levo isomer is more active than dextro isomer. Example, the levoephedrine is 3.5 times more active than dextro isomer. Another one, levoergotamine is 3 to 4 times more active than dextroergotamine. Exceptions are D-tubo-quinarine is more active than levoisomer. Levoisomer of quinine is used to treat malaria. Dextroisomer of quinidine is used to treat arrhythmia. Both are active. Last exception, both racemic form, that is dextro and levo form of atropine, is active. Next one, general tests. Alkaloids are generally identified with the following tests. First one, Mayer's test, in which the alkaloidal solution is treated with potassium mercuric iodide. It gives cream color precipitation. Second test, Dragondorff's test, in which the alkaloidal solution is treated with potassium bismuth iodide. It gives reddish brown color precipitation. Third one, Wagner's test. Same here, the alkaloidal solution is treated with iodine in potassium iodide solution. It produces reddish brown color precipitation. Fourth one, Hager's test, in which the alkaloidal solution is treated with saturated picric acid. Picric acid solution is yellow in color, so it produces yellow color precipitation. Here, how we have to remember this Mayer's, Dragondorff's and Wagner's reagent. Mayer's reagent, potassium mercuric iodide. Here potassium iodide common, M means Mayer's, potassium mercuric iodide. In Dragondorff's reagent, potassium iodide common, B. D nearest alphabet, B, potassium bismuth iodide. In Wagner's test, Wagner's reagent, iodine in potassium iodide. Potassium iodide is prepared by the iodine in potassium hydroxide. This is the simplest way to remember these reagents. Fifth one, tannic acid test, in which the alkaloid solution is treated with a few drops of tannic acid solution. It produces buff color precipitation. Last test, ammonia renicate test, in which the alkaloid solution is treated with acidified ammonia renicate solution. It produces pink flocculent precipitation. Next, finally, previously asked either GPAT or GATE questions. First one, Wagner test is used to detect the presence of alkaloids. Second question, one of the following general characteristics is not true for alkaloids. Alkaloids, nitrogen in heterocyclic nucleus, which is correct. Good solubility in organic solvent, which is correct. pKa less than 7, which is wrong. Alkaloids have pKa more than 7. They exhibit optical activity, already we have studied. Last one, which one of the following is true for alkaloidal bases? Water solubility and organic solvent insolubility. Water insolubility and organic solvent insolubility. Water solubility and organic solvent solubility. Water insolubility and organic solvent solubility. Alkaloid bases are soluble in organic solvents but insoluble in water. Answer is D. I hope you like this video. For more videos, please like, share, subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.